The next question is actually not asked by anybody, but I'm just going to put it out there. It's like a very important quality that you need to have as a composer is managing your own time, but also the time of others. It's so important. I noticed this when I came to LA. I was green behind the ears. I had no idea what was going on here. And I started interning for great composers here in town, like Harry Gregson-Williams, Klaus Badelt, and with a few other people. And I really understood how important it is to manage your time. You need to know what needs to be done at a certain point. It's not just the cues, but you gotta think far ahead of things. Like, when do things need to go to orchestration? When do we need to start printing stems? How do we anticipate potential delays that go on? And you need to manage other people's time too. My assistants, your orchestrators, your engineer that will record your score. Everything needs to be planned ahead. And you need to know of yourself too, how much music am I able to produce in one day while at the same time I'm doing all these managing jobs. I'm on the phone a lot. I talk to my music editors. I talk to the studio. I talk to the director. So you talk to all these different people, and at the same time you need to make music. At the same time, I need to sit down with my assistants to make sure that they know what they need to do. So managing your time is very important, and how to deal with them. So one of the tricks that I've used is I still use an old school notepad. I write stuff down. I've developed a talent somehow, I don't know where it comes from, where I'm able to pretty much remember everything that I need to do and in an orderly fashion. But just to make sure as a backup, I have an iPhone, but it works the same on any system. I put everything into calendars, I put alarms in there, so I get little pings that I need to take care of this or need to take care of that. Don't forget to call that person, don't forget to sent the lineup to the orchestrator, to the contractor. So a lot of it is in place. So it's very important that if you're not organized yourself, then you need to hire somebody who is super organized and who will do it for you. I've known composers that are completely like, you know, they're like washheads, you know, like they can't remember anything, they can't remember that they have a meeting or that they need to do this or that because they're so like captured by the creative process. If that's the case, you need to have somebody who will take care of that for you, because you cannot miss a meeting, you cannot miss a phone call, you cannot call somebody not back. It just doesn't work. So in my case, I'm on the verge of still able being taken care of all these issues myself. Maybe in the future, when it gets really crazy busy, I maybe need to get somebody else to help me with that. But at this point, I'm fine doing it on my own. I don't do my business on my own. I work with my very talented manager and friend already for more than 20 years, Mikul, my agent Amos. So within the three of us, they take care of the business side, and I'm just taking care of the creative side. But the creative side needs a lot of managing and a lot of thinking how you work your time and how to get things done like in time. So I hope that's helpful too.